Morning. It's currently 7:30 a.m. Lexi! Next! Smile. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Sorry for being a little bit MIA the past couple of weeks. I have basically just switched off completely from work, from the gym, from everything. So I've not been filming YouTube or editing it or anything, but I am back. I'm back on the YouTube grind, I promise you that. I'm just about to get ready for the gym. I'm just gonna put these Murad skincare eye patches on, masks, because I had the worst sleep of my life last night. It was one of those sleeps, you know, where you literally just did not sleep at all. I was just literally staring at the ceiling all night thinking, what am I actually doing with my life? Because Anton was fast asleep next to me. I was so jealous. Anyway, I'm quite tired this morning. But as you will have seen, I got like just a couple little clips of it. Hold on. Okay, they're on now. But yeah, as you will have seen, me and Anton actually went on a little walk this morning. As soon as we woke up, we literally just threw on some coats and stuff. I actually left my hoodie on because I'm just like, nobody's gonna see me, it's dark, I'm going out in my hoodie. But yeah, we took Dexter out on a little walk, literally like 15 minutes, if that. Just because I've heard that there's so many amazing benefits to like exposing yourself to daylight. Not that there was any daylight because it's winter and it's dark, but like as soon as you wake up, apparently it's really, really good for you, and obviously just to like expose yourself to like fresh air and stuff. So that's what we did, and I feel much more alive and awake. As you will have seen, for breakfast as well, we had some egg whites, chicken sausages and toast. We actually got those egg whites from my gym yesterday. They actually sell them at reception, like in a fridge and stuff, and they weren't the nicest, but you know, they're easy and convenient. You just squeeze them into a pan. So yeah, that's what we had for breakfast, and I'm just about to get ready for the gym. I'm actually just gonna film a TikTok as well because I've never done one of these before, like a talk through get ready with me. And I feel like I'd like to post one of these on TikTok just because you can post anything on TikTok and it's allowed. So I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna pick my gym fit with everyone. And you guys, I wish this was like real time and you could pick it with me. Yeah, we're training push today. I'm actually training with Anton today because I think he's going home tomorrow or the day after. So yeah, we're gonna get like a last session in together before he goes home, but that will of course be filmed in this vlog. But in this video, I just kind of wanted to talk about what I'm doing to kind of get back on track. Just talking you through some of like the healthy habits that I have created for myself this year, because there's a couple of new ones. Yeah, I'm gonna talk you through all that. Everything 2023, new year. Oh yeah, happy new year everyone as well, by the way, didn't even say that. Let me know in the comments what your 2023 goals are, because I'd love to know. Right, so I'm training push today. So I'm thinking leggings, because it's very cold as well. And I kind of want some blues. So I think I'm gonna go with these Timeless leggings from Honor in Midnight. These are like such a nice upper body leggings, so comfy and so buttery as well. I'm gonna go for a micro brow look, so I'm gonna go for light denim. I'm gonna go for a whole blue outfit, and then I'm gonna put my Timeless jacket on top of it as well. Right, this is the jacket I'm gonna go for. It's like a little crop jacket, so I'm gonna go put that on now. Alright, I've taken the eye patches off, guys. Let me show you the outfit. As I said, I'm wearing Timeless in both the leggings and the jacket. And then this is the Effortless Micro Bralette. Going for an all blue moment today, but as you can probably tell, it is hair wash day today. So I'm gonna go to the gym in my hair mask and stuff and my rosemary oil. I'm gonna kind of like show you my routine, but I'm also filming a TikTok as well, so I'm gonna actually talk to my phone, but you can listen in as well. It's the exact same advice, I'm just not gonna be looking at you. All right, so first off, I go in with my rosemary oil. I've started using rosemary oil in my hair, and I probably use way too much than what you're supposed to, because I've heard that you're not supposed to use much at all. But that was like one full pump on one side of my hair. And then put it on this side. Then I'll just put another little pump on the back of my head. I just like to massage that in. My hair's all frizzy because like, I've had it in plaits. But I'm currently on my like hair growth journey, if you couldn't tell already. And I've actually seen so much hair growth from like doing this routine every single time before I actually wash my hair. I only wash my hair once a week as well, which I think really helps a lot. But I'm just gonna like massage it in, because apparently that helps with hair growth as well. But after that, I'm gonna go in with my Olaplex number 3, scalp to ends. So I'm just gonna put this everywhere. I use my Olaplex shampoo and conditioner as well when I wash my hair. All right, and then before we slick it back, I'm gonna go in with this hair mask. I got this from Look Fantastic. It's from a brand called Sheer Moisture. And I quite like these masks, to be fair. They're quite good. I've noticed my hair's really soft and shiny after I use it. Please excuse the fake tan on my hand as well. It just went wrong. You know, the hands are a tricky topic. Going to the gym, smelling like bread. Lovely. And then I'm actually just gonna top that off with a teeny bit of hairspray, just so that it's set in place. All right, guys, that is it for the gym. I love a slick back, no makeup look for the gym. Here is the fit. I'm not sure, I think this jacket is out of stock, but I think these leggings are still in stock, and they are literally the most like soft buttery leggings ever. But yeah, I'm gonna go train push with Anton. He's patiently just waiting next to me at the moment, which I will film for you. That will be up soon. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed. All right, this is the hair done, all hair masked and oiled up and everything like that. But yeah, no makeup, hair mask, hair wash day, and we're gonna go train push. This is the outfit, as you will have seen. Sorry, there's just a shopping bag on the floor. I'm not really sure why.
You kicked it there.
Yeah, good one. Do you wanna say hi? Anton wants to say hi, so there he is. In all his glory. He's been waiting patiently while he's been revising. But I'm gonna put some socks on. That'd be a good idea, wouldn't it? Oh my God, I actually need to update you, right? Okay, so me and Anton were on the way to the gym on New Year's Day. So it's now the 4th of January. And this is our second gym session of the year, because basically I broke down on the motorway on Monday. I think it was Monday. And yeah, we literally couldn't get rescued for like so long. And my tyre basically just like popped on the motorway. It was kind of scary. It just went like, and I was like, oh fuck. So we pulled over onto the hard shoulder, but the hard shoulder, like we literally got onto the last bit of it. So like we literally were on the chevrons of the hard shoulder. Like we literally just cusped it. Otherwise we would have had to carry on driving.
I don't think it's called a chevron.
But like the lines at the end of the hard shoulder to indicate that it's ending, we were on those. So we got really lucky. Yeah, it was quite scary. Anyway, we didn't make it to the gym then. And then my car was in for repairs for a day. So we ended up having to go to the gym a couple of days later, which was annoying, but it is what it is. We're back to it now. And it's just like one of those jobs that I needed to get done for ages, because my tire depth was like shocking anyway. So I'm kind of glad that it's been done now, because the guy that did my tires was like saying that it's basically, it was only a matter of time before the other one was gonna go. So I'm glad I got it fixed. It was obviously one of those annoying situations in the moment, but I'm glad that it's done now. And hopefully I don't have any other problems. All right, guys, I've just got to the gym. Anton, say hi. Say hi then.
Hi then.
We're just about to train push, as I already said. Don't turn it up.
We're just about to train push.
We're gonna do bench press, and we're both gonna hopefully go for some PBs. I did 55 kg before Christmas, but it wasn't the greatest rep, so I'm gonna try it again. My goal is to get 60, literally in like hopefully very soon. But I do need Anton to help me with it, so I might not be able to do it again until he comes home. So maybe in a couple of months, I'll have 60 in the bag. But I'm going to show you the whole session. Anton's my cameraman.
As always.
As always. But he's just going to put a hype song on. By the way, the new Metro Boomin album. Sick. I don't want to know if you're really keeping on the
Heroes
low.
And Villains.
It's called Heroes
and
Villains.
Oh, it came out December the 2nd.
Oh, yes, it is new.
Yeah, it's pretty new.
Heroes and Villains. Go give it a listen. On my playlist as well, there's some songs on it.
Metro. On
so, if you also want my playlist, I'll link it in the description. Because it's a banging one, isn't it?
No, it's not.
It is.
No, there's too much Drake in there.
Anton doesn't like Drake. He's a hater.
I like some of Drake.
Drake's quite a fruity guy. I don't think Anton likes that.
No, it's not that.
You just think he's like cringe, don't you?
I just think he's overplayed.
All right, guys, I'm just about to do my pre-workout routine. I'm having some Pride from EHP. I'm just going to put my coat back. So I'm just going to have some Pride from EHP. I'm going to be having the Voodoo flavor. If you want to get any supplements from EHP, you can use my code Mia, which will get you 10% off. But yeah, I'm just going to have one scoop of this, and hopefully it just pushes me on to hit this PB on bench.
It's happened. It's fine, don't worry.
Like a warm-up, please. Thanks.
No, I am.
guys, we've just finished our session. Pretty good one all round. I didn't feel like the strongest just because this is like my first upper body session after being off for like 2 weeks. We did a session yesterday, but that was the first one back. The last one we did was on the 23rd of December and it's now the 4th. So it's to be expected to not feel as strong as normal, but it's still good, wasn't it? This is probably our last push session together for a while. So yeah, I'm gonna have to bench on my own. Probably no 60 kilograms for a while, but I hope you enjoyed the footage. Obviously it's helpful, and Tom being able to get good angles because my camera's just usually on the floor. But we're just gonna have a protein bar. Anton's having PhD.
PhD smart bar. Christmas present. I got like a box of 20 of them from my cousin.
And then I've got a grenade bar from the gym. But we're just gonna eat these and then drive home. But once I get home, I'm gonna talk to you about what this actual video is about. So don't worry, this video is actually gonna be about something. All right guys, I just got back home and I wanted to actually touch on what this video is about. And that is just about getting back on track this New Year's, you know, like building up some healthy habits, whether they be new or you're just kind of resuming ones that you already had before the new year. I know that for me, at the end of the year, last year, literally like a few days ago, I have really fallen off with my nutrition, my training, everything like that, and I am not mad about it whatsoever. I enjoyed the period as much as I possibly could. I switched off from work, I switched off from training for almost 2 weeks and ate whatever I wanted. And I thoroughly enjoyed it and I feel now well rested. And I do think that a kind of break like that sometimes is needed. Even if you are just losing motivation or you feel like you've hit a plateau a little bit and you just need to kind of be realigned with some new goals, and it really just makes you think about your why you started your fitness journey. And yeah, sometimes just taking some time off is amazing just to gain a little bit of clarity. So I hope you've all enjoyed the festive period. I hope you've not been like too hard on yourselves and stuff and feeling guilty for being off track. It's completely normal, and obviously, as I always say, your fitness journey is timeless, it's forever, and it should be as sustainable as possible. So having a couple of weeks off out of whatever months, years of your training is not going to affect your progress, because I know a lot of people will be worrying at this kind of time of year, at the start of the year, a lot of people worry that their progress has just kind of like gone down the drain. You might feel a little bit bloated and puffier and more fatigued and stuff, but that is to be expected when you've kind of not been eating the best foods and you've been off track a little bit. It's normal to feel more bloated and hold a little bit more water weight. It doesn't necessarily mean that you've just like gained loads of weight over a couple of weeks. It doesn't work like that. But yeah, after eating a lot of shit, your body holds on to a lot more water, which is why you may be feeling and looking a little bit more bloated. So don't worry. You don't need to compensate for like the bad eating. I don't like to call any eating bad, but you don't need to compensate for being off track. You don't need to go absolutely crazy and do things that are unsustainable. Just carry on with your routine like it was before. And yeah, you don't need to do anything crazy to get back on track, I promise. Please don't be stressing. Hear it from me. My body's not changed at all. And I ate a full chocolate orange the other night, most days actually. And I just ate whatever I wanted and I just looked the same. So please don't worry about that. But yeah, I wanted to talk about how I'm kind of going to be getting back on track this year. My motivation is so high at the moment. Obviously, as I said, taking some time off can really just help to increase motivation levels. Sometimes when you just like go, go, go all the time, it's obviously easy to see motivation declining. You can burn yourself out a lot. So a break is sometimes very much needed. But yeah, I need to get straight to the point. So how I'm getting back on track is I am resuming the same routine I was before. I'm not doing anything crazy. However, I have kind of created a couple of new healthy habits that I want to implement into my daily, hopefully, routine. Maybe not every single day, but I'm going to try and implement them into my routine as much as possible. And one of those is to reduce my screen time. Now, social media and like content creating and everything is my full-time job, so reducing my screen time is a little bit harder than like the average person. Obviously, it's like my work, I'm on it more than the average person, but when I wasn't working, I found myself just like scrolling aimlessly on apps that just were not providing any useful benefit to me. So I'm really gonna try, this might sound like so much to some people, but obviously editing videos and stuff like that takes a long time, but I'm gonna try and reduce it
or like have it 4 hours or less each day. That might be like, what the hell, that is so much for me, for some people. But for me, you know, it was, please don't judge me for this, but it was literally on like 10 hours a day, and that's just like, that's just not good. So I'm gonna try and have it 4 hours or less. And to be honest, I have been doing that really. Like this morning, I didn't go on it all morning really. Went to the toilet, and if you know what I mean, I can't go to the toilet like that without my phone, because you know that thing when you just go to the toilet and you know you're in the toilet for a long time, you know what I'm trying to say, and you don't have your phone, and you just end up like reading all the labels on the bottles because you just don't have your phone, and I'm just bored out of my mind. So I went on it then, but we went to the gym and everything like that, and I put it on Do Not Disturb, which I'm going to be doing a lot more. Yeah, I had it on Do Not Disturb in the gym, and obviously I've been driving home, and I think my screen time today will probably be about half an hour, and it's about 1 o'clock, so that's great for me. Love that for me at the moment, and it just makes me feel a lot better, because it's not that it puts me in a negative headspace, it just makes me really unproductive, and I just find myself just sitting on it when I could be doing something productive. So yeah, talking about this morning, which you will have seen a couple little clips of, but I'm going to try and start implementing like a 10 to 15 minute walk outside as soon as I wake up in the morning. Now, it's a lot harder at this time of year because, as you will have seen, it was literally pitch black. But me and Anton went with Dexter, and it was cute, and it really just woke me up. And I don't know, I think there's, I've read something that there's really positive benefits. There's really positive benefits that have been proven if you expose yourself to kind of like daylight, not that there's really any daylight, but just kind of like the outside world as soon as you wake up. So, and I did feel much more like fresh and awake afterwards. So I'm going to try and start doing that more often. Obviously it will be much easier to do in the summertime. I'll definitely stick to it in the summertime, you know, in the mornings are light and sunny and warm and stuff, but in the moment it is a little bit harder. But yeah, I just didn't even look at my phone this morning. I just left my hoodie on, put my coat on, and we just literally went straight out for about 10-15 minutes. Got back, made breakfast, still hadn't gone on my phone. And yeah, then we set off for the gym, and here we are now. But yeah, as you will know, I am still bulking, so I went a couple of weeks without tracking any calories. So I probably wasn't in the surplus that I was in before, so I'm looking to resume that starting today. I'm started tracking today. So yeah, that is what's gone on. I'm trying to keep as on track as possible with my nutrition, with my training. I have actually restarted my 12-week guide. I'm on week one at the moment, and yeah, I just love it. It's just there. It's ready for me when I get into the gym, and I don't need to worry about what I'm doing or anything like that. We didn't actually do it today just because I was with Anton, and he likes to create the workouts when we're training together. But yeah, my guide is actually on sale at the moment. I don't think it will be when you're watching this, but it was on sale this week for like the first week of January, because I know a lot of people might need a little bit of inspiration going back to the gym this month. As I know, a lot of gyms will be busier at this time of year, which I also do want to mention, if you are a beginner in the gym this January, you know, if you've decided to start your fitness journey, then I want to give you 3 bits of advice. Number one would be, don't care what anyone thinks about you. Honestly, no one cares what you're doing, no one's looking at you, and if they are, then it's their own problem, just ignore it, you know what I mean? Just do what you want to do. I feel like it's 2023, life is too short to be worrying about people's opinions. Like, we live on a floating rock. Do you know what I mean? So just do you, do whatever you want. What are people actually going to say to you? What are they going to do? Nothing. So do what you want. And then I would say, stick to a solid plan that will do you wonders. Doing here, like if you enjoy doing whatever you want, then do that. But if you are looking to gain the best results, then I would recommend sticking to a solid program for weeks and months at a time to gain the best progress possible. But obviously I'm not forcing you to. If you don't want to do that, then don't do it. Just do whatever you want. And then the third point I would say would be to keep it as sustainable as possible. I know that a lot of people, if they're starting their fitness journey, they just kind of throw themselves into the deep end, and it's just not sustainable at all. You run the risk of just kind of burning out when you do that, and obviously depending on whatever lifestyle you have, if you've created kind of like daily goals for yourself that are just not attainable and you see other people doing but you just can't achieve personally, then you're not going to get anywhere. Don't just copy what somebody else is doing. Like, I went out for a walk this morning. Some people just simply don't have time for that. So you don't need to implement that if you don't have time. You need to figure out what goals work with your routine and just what can be the most sustainable as possible, because that is what you want. You want your journey, your fitness journey is forever. It's not just for a couple of months, a few weeks. It's not till you get your summer body. Your fitness journey should be forever. So find a routine that you are able to sustain forever. That is the point summed up. That is the main point, because I see a lot of people say, oh, I'm in it, like I'm ready to smash these goals, and then by February the 1st they've just kind of burnt themselves out and they just say, I can't keep up with it, I can't keep going, things like that. So yeah, make sure you create goals that are sustainable for you and achievable for you. And then some tips for people that are in the gym already, they've been on the fitness journey for a long time and they're obviously going back to the gym in January. Please be patient with people that are beginners. I see a lot of things online actually like bashing beginners in the gym, and I find it really harsh because obviously everybody starts somewhere, and if you are that person that is starting on their day one and you see someone that's on their day, I don't know, 300, it just makes that person not want to go to the gym, which is not what we want. The gym is supposed to be like a welcome space for absolutely everyone. That's what I always preach about. So yeah, please just be patient with people. Obviously everybody starts somewhere, as I said, not everyone has it all figured out straight away. I don't even have it all figured out and I've been going to the gym for years. Do you know, I still bash my head on the cable machines or something. It's just completely normal. So yeah, please be patient with people, give people a chance and time, and yeah, everyone's in there to better themselves. Nobody is better than anyone else. You're all paying equally for that gym membership. So yeah, all I'm saying is have some patience, and I hope you're all enjoying 2023 so far. I love seeing everyone's kind of motivation like going like up on Instagram and stuff. Like, I've been getting so many story tags of you all being really motivated this year, which is making me really motivated, and I'm just so excited to get stuck into my split and stuff and get stuck into my nutrition and everything like that, and just putting out the best content possible for you guys. So yeah, please let me know if you have any content suggestions for kind of 2023, if you want to see more what I eat in a days or whatever. But yeah, this is going to be my kind of like getting back on track routine, how I'm starting 2023. One thing I also forgot to mention is that I made a promise to myself that I am going to start prioritizing my recovery in 2023, my recovery and my stretching and everything like that. So I am officially going to start stretching every single day. I've done it for the past 2 days and I'm already more flexible. Like, can you believe it? So yeah, doing stretches every day is so important. It helps your flexibility, it helps your mobility, and yeah, it just helps with recovery in general. As I was saying, it's really important to do your stretching. But I'm going to close this video off because my battery is flashing. And yeah, I'm going to die, but I hope you love this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!